Hello guys, welcome to Cigar Makers. So in this lecture we'll be discussing about the design criteria of your pile foundation. So pile foundation has been covered in IS 2911. So in this code, this IS 2911, we have four parts. Part 1 talks about concrete piles, part 2 timber piles, part 3 underream piles, part 4 load test on pile. So except part 4, all the three parts is regarding the design of different types of pile. Part 1 is further classified in three sections. Section 1 consists of this driven cast in situ concrete piles. Section 2 consists of bored cast in situ concrete piles. And section 3, driven precast concrete piles as per IS 2911. So this 2010 is the revision year of this pile foundation code as per Indian standard. So this is the introduction of IS 2911. So we will be just discussing the clause, the code provisions of driven cast in situ pile, which comes under IS 2911 part 1 section 1. So before going into IS 2911 part 1 section 1 and follow the design criteria, we will just discuss pile foundation basic components. So what are the components of pile foundations? So first, pile foundation is required. Pile foundation requirement, we have already discussed, where soil is not good quality, soil condition is not good, then this is just the requirement of, and where your structural loading is very high. So structural load is very high, load high. So now we will just go through quickly. We did this already, we have uploaded this part, introduction on pile cap, pile design. So we'll quickly go to the components of pile, components of pile foundation. So I'll just write a shortcut of foundation, FDN. So we have two components, pile and pile cap. So today in this lecture we'll be learning about the criteria, how to design pile and pile cap. This pile, we need the capacity of pile. So based on the soil investigation report, then 2911 clauses, the pile capacity is given to the structural engineer by the geotechnical consultant. So pile capacity will be your capacity, vertical load capacity, that is vertical load capacity and lateral thrust. So based on the pile capacity, you will decide how many piles per foundation you require. So like, let's assume 100 ton load is coming from the column, reaction from column, 100 ton vertical reaction, and your pile capacity is 30 tons, whether end bearing or friction pile we will discuss later on, but let's say the pile capacity is 30 tons. So the number of piles will be 100 tons divided by 30, which is equals to 3.33. so we are providing four number of piles. So in order to connect these four numbers of pile, we need this pile cap. So now these two components, this pile and pile cap, has been described, like what is the requirement of this pile and what is the requirement of this pile cap. Pile will transfer the superstructure load to the foundation, to the soil, through this pile, and pile cap is the connection between the number of piles, that is group of piles and the column. So this was regarding the component of your pile capacity, pile design, pile foundation. So we have already gone through the pile foundation components. So now we will discuss the clauses of 2911 part 1 section 1 2010. So IS 2911, first of all we have pile. So we will look into the clause related to was related to pile. Then we have pile cap. So clause related to pile cap. So first, while designing a pile, what are the consideration? So first consideration, your dia of pile, your minimum reinforcement of pile, minimum numbers of bar required in pile, minimum size of bar. So these are the major things which we need to consider while designing the pile. So dia of pile as per pile capacity, as per capacity will be decided. Minimum reinforcement 0.4%, which has been defined under clause 6.11, this part. Minimum numbers of bar, 6 numbers minimum you have to provide for a circular pile. Width, that minimum size of the bar is 12 mm. So this is the minimum criteria of pile. So if you are designing a pile, so your bar dia should not be less than 12 mm, your number of bar should not be less than 6 mm in case of circular pile, your minimum reinforcement throughout the entire length of pile should not be less than 0.4% as per, and the dia of the pile is as per pile capacity. So this was regarding the pile. There are few more things regarding pile we will discuss when we'll refer the clause of this. So these are the general criteria, general requirement of a pile design. Now pile cap. So for pile cap we have this clause 6.12 of this. So we will discuss clause 6.12. So the most important clause we will discuss is clause 6.6, which talks about spacing of piles. Then clause 6.5.21, where the criteria for group of piles has been defined. Then clause 6.11, clause 6.12. Clause 6.11 talks about your minimum reinforcement of pile, and clause 6.12 pile cap design. So let's, the spacing we will just discuss. The spacing between pile for your end bearing is 2.5 times your dia of pile, and for friction piles 3.0 dia of your pile. So we will confirm these spacings. We will just confirm these spacing. We will go to this IS 2911. So IS 2911, we will just immediately go to the clause for, let's go to the clause first. We will just go through clause where your group of piles need to be. So clause 6.5.21 suggests a group of 3 or more piles connected by a rigid pile cap shall be considered to have fixed head conditions. Caps for single piles must be interconnected by grade beams. If that means if you have a single pile, then you should provide a grade beam in two direction. So grade beam in two direction if you are providing a single pile. In case you are providing a double pile, twin piles, by grade beams in a line transverse common to the axis of pair, so that the pile head is fixed. So that means the most important criteria is to make the pile head fixed condition. In other condition, the pile shall be taken as free headed. So this is regarding if you are providing, so basically this clause suggests if you are providing a single pile, then you have to provide a grade beam. If you are providing in two direction, if you are providing multiple, then more than two piles, then these criteria can be revised. So now we will go to 6.6 for spacing of pile. So next is the spacing of pile, which will decide the pile cap the width. So like if we have column column load 50 ton from column. Pile capacity, pile capacity 40 ton. So number of piles 150 by 40, that means it is almost 4 piles. So for an end bearing pile, this the distance between two center to center between two piles should not be less than 2.5 times d, that is 2.5 times dia of your pile. So we can just check that clause. So the minimum center to center spacing while considered from these aspects, namely practical aspects of installing the piles. So we are not we will just diameter of the piles, nature of the load transferred to the soil and problem. So look at the clause. In case of piles founded on hard stratum and deriving their capacity mainly from end bearing piles, I said end bearing pile, minimum spacing shall be 2.5 times the dia of this pile shaft. In case of piles resisting on rock, the spacing of 2 times, like if it is resting on rock, so this will decrease to 2 times. So there is a difference between a pile resting on rock and a hard strata. Hard strata can be anything other than a rock. So pile deriving their load carrying capacity mainly from friction shall be spaced sufficiently apart to ensure that zones of shear. So in case of friction pile, it should not be less than 3 times the dia of the pile shaft. So for end bearing pile, 2.5 times d. For hard strata, 2.0 times d. For rock, then friction pile, it's 3 times d. So based on this, so like we in previous problem, we have got a clear depth, clear the center to center width as 1 point, let's say it is an end bearing pile, so 2.5 times d. If we are using 500 mm dia, so 2.5 times 500, that means it is 1500. So 1.5 times 1.5 meter this direction, 1.5 meters this direction, and there will be a minimum, at least you should provide the edge distance should be minimum d, so that is at least 500. So this the approximate width size of this pile cap will be 1.5 plus 0.5, 1.5. So that means 1.5 plus 0.5 plus 0.5. So that it is equals to 2.5 into 2.5. So this will be the dimension of your pile cap. Regarding the depth and reinforcement detailing, we will be discussing later stage. So this is how we decide the pile cap dimension based on the codal provision. So now factor of safety. So for factor of safety of your pile, you have to consider, like if your actual pile capacity, like your pile capacity as per soil condition, it is coming around 1100 ton. So the ultimate, that means the design ultimate pile capacity will be met. Spelling mistake, you just ignore the spelling mistake. So ultimate pile capacity shall be 1000 divided by 2.5. That means it is 100 divided by 2.5. Sometimes is 40, so 40 ton capacity. So this is how we this IS 2911 has suggested. The minimum factor of safety on static formula shall be 2.5. So clause 6.8 suggest the factor of safety of your pile, the capacity of your pile should be decided. Now 6.11, as I mentioned, the minimum area of longitudinal reinforcement of any type, the minimum area of longitudinal reinforcement, that is main reinforcement, shall be 0.4% of cross-sectional area of the pile shaft. The minimum reinforcement shall be provided throughout the length of the shaft. So clause 6.11 suggests the minimum reinforcement regarding the stirrups. Regarding the stirrups, it suggests you should provide minimum dia of stirrups as 8 mm, and the spacing should not be less than 150 mm. The minimum diameter of the links or spires shall be 8 mm, and the spacing of the links shall not be greater than 150 mm. And also, the clear cover to all main reinforcement in piles shall be not less than 50 mm. So clear cover, so clear cover in pile, so this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let's say 6. So it's minimum that criteria 6 numbers, this dia minimum 12 mm, and this clear cover this should not be less than 50 mm, should not be less than 50 mm, should be greater than 50 mm. So we'll go back to the clear cover shall to all the main reinforcement in pile shaft shall be not less than 50 mm. So this was regarding the pile design. We have minimum reinforcement criteria 0.4%, minimum cover 50 mm, and then we have factor of safety 2.5. then we have this end bearing piles reinforcement also we have designed. Now we will close this minimum. We have this minimum 6 numbers, as I said. Clause 6.12 suggest 6.11.4. So 6.114 says minimum 6 numbers of vertical bar shall be used for circular pile, and minimum dia of vertical bar shall be 12 mm. So design of pile caps is covered under clause 6.12. So the method and analysis of pile cap is similar to your other concrete members like your foundations, raft. So it, only the spacing and these criteria are covered under this section. Otherwise, the design criteria is similar to IS 456. These clause you need to understand. The pile cap shall be deep enough to allow necessary anchorage. So for that, IS 2911 has given certain limitation, like the anchorage should not be less than 75 mm. The pile cap is generally cast over a 75 mm thick leveling course. The embedment of pile into the pile cap should be 75 mm. So embedment should be 75 mm. The design of grade beam, if used, as I said, if you are using one pile, then you have to provide a grade beam, and that is covered under IS 2911 part 3. The clear cover for main reinforcement in the cap. So clear cover for your pile was 50 mm. The clear cover for your pile cap shall not be less than 60 mm, and the pile cap should rest on a 75 mm thick leveling course of, that is your PCC. So you cannot provide a PCC of 50 mm or less than 75 mm. So for pile cap, we have these limitations: clear cover 60 mm minimum, then PCC, resting on PCC minimum, it should be 75 mm minimum. Then anchorage of pile should be 75 mm. So these are the consideration as per, and the design will be as per normal RCC design, that is IS 456. So this was regarding the design consideration of your pile cap and your pile foundation. So in case if we have missed anything regarding this, regarding concentration of pile cap and pile design, so we can you can raise your query. We will try to clarify those query and we will try to include those things. One more thing I have just missed, the minimum grade of concrete should be M25. So as per IS 2911, the minimum grade of concrete shall be 25 M25 M25 concrete grade. The so this concrete grade minimum M25 for your pile design. So in case if you have any query, any doubt, you can always comment. We will try to clarify all your comments and we will try to cover most of the topics related to pile foundation design. So this was regarding design consideration of your piled foundations. In a previous video, I have explained the types of pile foundation and introduction of pile foundations. So in the upcoming videos, we will be designing actual pile foundations. So you'll be clear, you'll get used to these terms like end bearing piles. You have this things for 0.4%. So we will actually see these. So thank you. Have a nice day. Please subscribe to my channel and keep sharing our videos. If you have any doubt, you can always comment. We will try to clarify all your comments. Thank you. Have a nice day and goodbye.